Please welcome to the stage Lieutenant Governor Casey Cagle.
Thank you all very, very much. It is indeed a great honor to be here today. They were hazing me in the back, I might add, because they said, "You're not going to take 30 minutes, are you?" I assured them that I would not. But it is great to be back. I get a round of applause for 20, for agreeing to that. It's great to be here. I spoke this morning at the breakfast and I shared with them, you know, a little bit of my journey. And when you come to occasions like this, individuals that have given so much of their time and resources for decades, I think about 1994 when I was first elected to the state Senate. You could literally put the Republican Party in Hall County in a phone booth in that day. We had a guy by the name of Gordon Sawyer, an individual who had ran for the state Senate 2 years earlier. And he came up with a slogan, and it was "Vote Conservative, Vote Republican." And we took that message all across that county. As you can imagine, being the first elected state senator, I couldn't raise any money. But I did have enough people in the chicken business that would help out and enough friends to where we could barbecue chicken and sell them for $10 a plate and raise $20,000 and ended up winning by 56% of the vote. The reason we did that is because we organized a grassroots campaign. We had phone booths, we had individuals going door to door, and we didn't have any choice. But today, we are much more blessed because we're in the majority. We have the ability to raise money and have resources that traditionally we would not have had. The key for us is to continue to remember where we came from, to never let go of those things, those fundamentals that we have to build upon in order to continue within to be prosperous as a party. The other thing that I will tell you is that we have to always be mindful not only of where we've come from, but also where we're going. The thing that makes the Republican Party so special is that we are not a party like the Democrats who believe in socialism and liberalism. What we believe in fundamentally is prosperity and opportunity. What we believe in is no matter where you come from, no matter what your circumstances, you can always end up successfully because we don't believe in a handout, but a hand up. It's fundamentally different, and it's who makes us different and unique. What always encourages me is when we have those special opportunities that remind us the reason that we're here. As many of you know, education has been a huge platform for me, an issue that I care passionately about. And the college and career academies and the charter systems that we created and the prosperity that's been created as a result of that has been very special. But what is the most unique thing is sitting down with a student in a part of our state. I sat there with this young lady and she said to me, she said, "A year ago, I would not have been able to sit here and have a conversation with the Lieutenant Governor of the state of Georgia." She said, "But because of this college and career academy, because we're not referred to as students, referred to as associates. Our teachers are not teachers, they are instructors and mentors. It's a different relationship where we are expected to greet someone by a handshake and look them in the eye. That environment has changed her life, and today she is on a path for great success." Visited with a young girl named Jasmine, an African-American female right here in Clark County, enrolled in the College and Career Academy. Jasmine is not only going to graduate from high school, but she's also going to graduate with an associate's degree in criminal justice. The beautiful thing about the story with Jasmine is that she's going to go on and finish her criminal justice degree at the University of Georgia and then become a lawyer. She did all of that debt-free. And Jasmine is not looking back, she is looking forward. She is looking forward to a career that is poised for opportunity for her and generations to come. that's where our focus has to always remain, is making sure that, yes, we're providing an environment to where businesses can succeed, understanding that government doesn't create jobs, the private sector does, and government needs to continue to be lean and efficient and effective and get out of the way of business. But we also need to be mindful of the fact that opportunity exists everywhere. And we as a party believe, fundamentally, that you can achieve success on your own. And that's what we stand for. And each of you that are part of this cause, that are part of this calling to ensure that that prosperity will exist in your community and throughout the state, and are willing to get up each and every day and fight against socialism, fight against liberalism, and fight for liberty and the freedoms that we hold dear. I say thank you, I commend you for your commitment, and encourage you to continue to be united in our quest. United in our quest to continue to make a difference. Ronald Reagan said that those that vote with me 80% of the time are friends and allies. Those individuals that vote 20% of the time against me are not bad. It is important for us to always remember that a divided house will not stand, that we always have to be united and committed to a greater calling and a greater purpose. This party can continue to have a significant impact on the state and the nation if we will be true to our principles and we will be committed to making difference in public policy initiatives. That's the key. Each of you hold us accountable. I ask you to continue to do that, and let's go win the presidency in 2016. Thank you so much, and God bless you.